So, over the weekend, you may have heard or seen nude photos of celebrities were stolen off of their phones and posted online. It's a terrible invasion of privacy. But probably the most disconcerting part of this for me, this scandal, is that some people are blaming the celebrities for having the nude photos on their phone in the first place. For example, the New York Daily News said this, "This blame game shifts responsibility from an obvious fact. It just isn't wise to keep nude photos of yourself on your computer if you don't want them made public." Okay, so this leads us to a segment we do here at Late Night called Couple Things. First thing, the fact that we live in a world right now where technology lets two people send each other naked pictures of themselves is excellent. It is better than flying cars. The fact that you can be sitting at your desk at work, have your phone make a ping, and instead of an email from your boss saying, "Where's the Peterson report?" it's a text from someone special saying, "Hey, I have these, and I would like you to see them," is great. Let's not live in a world where that can't happen anymore. Second thing, it's never your fault if private naked pictures of you get out. And by the way, technology is getting to a point where soon all of our naked bodies will be caught by some camera somewhere. You'll be in your bedroom changing clothes at the same time an Amazon drone flies by your window to deliver your order of coffee pods. Now, all of a sudden, in some Amazon cloud, there's a naked picture of you bent over struggling to take off your socks. Will that be your fault? Will people say, "Hey, that's what you get for not changing in the closet with all the lights off"? If it doesn't have your consent, it's never your fault, period. Tangent thing. Does anyone like seeing pictures of a guy's dong? Does anyone get that on their cell phone and say, "Woo, look at this floppy piece of nonsense"? People call it their junk, and everyone seems all right with that. Yeah, it looks like junk. Of course, we're being honest, the most embarrassing thing on a guy's phone isn't the picture of his business he sent out. It's the first seven he took before the lighting and angle were right. You know, the one where the cat gets in the shot? Third thing, there are three kinds of people. Those who looked at the pictures, those who didn't, and those who tried to look, couldn't find them, gave up, and are now at dinner party saying, "You know what? It didn't seem right to look at them." To that last group, I'd like to say, you're not noble, you're just bad at the internet. Final thing, stop calling them hackers, they're thieves. Hackers are the cool geniuses in movies who are always the underdog, saying things like, "I cracked the mainframe, we're in," or, "There's one more thing I can try, but it's a long shot." This isn't Neo freeing mankind from slavery, this is perverts making money off of stolen goods. In summary, if you have a store that gets robbed, it's not your fault for having stuff people wanted. And the same goes for pictures on phones. With that said, everyone go home, change your passwords, because we live in a world full of monsters. This has been A Couple Things.